Good morning, Shindo here. This is a very short article, so I will comment on it after I read it. As always, if you like what I do, please subscribe, comment like an adult, like and share my videos. Herald Sun: Pope's Academy tells priests to teach global warming. Once the Catholic Church decreed the sun revolved around the earth, now this mad pope is at it again. From Catholic Online and via What's Up With That. New priests to learn about global warming as part of formation. The Catholic Church is intimately concerned about climate change. The Vatican's Pontiff Academy of Science is the world's oldest, longest-running scientific mission. That body, which advises the Pope on matters of science, has concluded that global climate change is real and is caused at least in a significant part by human activity. This is important to the Church because creation care is part of our mission. We are called to be stewards of creation. It is also important because climate change can exacerbate the ills of poverty. Poor people in much of the world are the most vulnerable to changes. Unfortunately, the issue is politicized. In the late 1970s, when the issue threatened the financial interest of the fossil fuel industry, the political lobbies, chiefly in the United States, financed a massive political disinformation campaign to manufacture the illusion of dissent within the scientific community. We know because the manipulation of public opinion has been caught and documented. The fossil fuel industry funds nearly all the climate change skeptics, going so far as to commission questionable studies, to finance think tanks, and even paying individual bloggers. The deception continues today. But what does this have to do with the Church? The Church has a responsibility to care for people and the environment, and care for one is also care for the other. Now, updated guidelines for the formation of clergy says new priests should understand this as well. Protecting the environment and caring for our common home, the earth, belong fully to the Christian outlook on man and reality. Priests should be, quote, promoters of an appropriate care for everything connected in the protection of creation, unquote. The new guidelines suggest that in the future, priests will also have a good grasp of the global climate change problem and will share this with their congregation. This pope is trying to turn the Church to a worship of a new god, Gaia. Obviously, this is an opinion piece, but I gave you the exact quotes, or the article gives the exact quotes from the Pope and the Vatican. I'm discussing this article not about climate change, because as far as I know, whether climate change is caused by human beings or not is debatable, and I'm not going to get into that debate. That's not the purpose of this video. If you notice, Trump is considering the head of Exxon Mobil to be his Secretary of State. He's also made it abundantly clear that the restrictions that were placed on businesses by the EPA are going to be lifted. So, the significance of this, what the Pope is saying, is that you're going to see a real battle going on between the Trump administration and the Pope and the Catholic Church. Many Catholics in this country, it seems, are falling away from the Church. They don't like the liberal bent of this new pope. And although this whole climate change thing may not be a major issue for you. It's not for me. I don't delve into it. It is almost the denial that human beings are responsible for climate change is almost like doctrine. It's dogma for the right evangelical, even the right, the Christian right. Now, the truth of the matter is that the Christian right is so indoctrinated, and so is the left. They're indoctrinated too in something that is in when it comes to climate change, it is like a religious belief, whether you believe it is caused by human beings or not. What I'm looking forward to, and I think we're going to see it in the next few years, is a major, major shift in the way that the Catholic Church is going to be treated by this coming administration. Now, I think of Trump, mind you, I'm glad that he's coming in because he is going to bring the chaos that I have been waiting for years now. I'm fully behind Trump going against the Catholic Church. Of course I am. The Catholic Church, more than any other institution, has murdered people all over the world. They have major blood on their hands. And as a Gnostic, when the Catholic Church is still speaking up against what I firmly hold as the truth, it's beyond belief for me. It is the truth, and that is that we ourselves are God, that God is within us, and we don't need a church to be handing down the way that we are supposed to think. That's what the Catholic Church wants to do, is incorporate their own way, a perspective of life and even death and afterlife. They want, well, what they are is a cancer, and they want to press their own ideas into your brain instead of you going with your gut. If you go with your gut, I guarantee you, you're going to know what's what. We have that discernment within us. We're born with it. We're born with it. And it's the Catholic Church, more than any other institution, that has indoctrinated people to believe that they are just dirty rags, that they are nothing, that they're nobody, and that they need to continue to come back to the church in order to appease this so-called loving God that's going to cast you into everlasting damnation. Don't believe it, folks. But believe this. The Trump administration, which will be more powerful than any other president ever, more powerful than Abraham Lincoln, which was Abraham Lincoln, I would say, was the most powerful president we've ever had, because he took the reins of a tyrant, really, more than any other president, and that's an aside. But Trump, being as powerful as he is and will be, he will go against the church, and it's a beautiful thing to see. And again, this was predicted by Revelation, the beast going after the whore of Babylon. Well, I guess that's your Sunday sermon for today. This is Shindo. Have a good Sunday.